Good morning, all of you. Nenu, me, Dr. Balaji Nujilla. Iroz mana topic, krindati varan lagane, kontamandi prekshakula vinapam meeda, alage chala mandiki ardham avvalani cheppesi. English lo kavali, English lo kontamandi cheppamani cheppi adigaru kabatti. Especially software engineers ki e-program anedi cheyadam jarugutundi. If we talk about spine, there are many mechanical issues which are related to spine for software engineers and those who are working with visual display units like laptops and all. In the present pandemic area or in the present pandemic situation, what we have is we have got a lot of issues, people. So we have got a number of people working from home, only few people going to the office. Whether you people are at home or at office, one thing you need to remember is the software engineers or those who are working continuously, the IT guys and the computer engineers and all, you need to have a proper care regarding your spine. Because more often than not, the large chunk of people what I get nowadays, largest chunk of people what I get nowadays are software engineers and IT guys who have been complaining about back pain, neck pain, and especially back pain. We have an idea that, or we have a predisposition that back pain is only lower back pain. No, it is the upper back pain also is one of the major concern nowadays. Most of the people land up having pain right from the neck to the shoulders to the upper back into the thorax part, or we call it as the upper back of it, then radiating or referring down to the lower back part of it. Also, because of these things, they will be complaining of numerous predisposed back induced hip pains and back induced leg pains. Now, how it is, it's a different concept. Why it is a different concept. It depends on the knowledge, the understandability of the individuals. But in this program, we are not discussing about the biomechanical aspect, because once I start discussing biomechanical aspects and all, it becomes more of a knowledge session or knowledge sharing rather than a session which is for the goodness or idea of you people, the IT guys. You people are not my students now. Basically, the main thing of this program is to educate you guys regarding your good postures, your bad postures, how to come out of the bad postures and all. So let's not go deep into the technical aspect of the back and biomechanics and all. Coming back to the spine, the first and the foremost thing you people will be suffering, the IT guys. The very word you people I refer to in this program is especially IT guys and VDU workers, visual display unit workers, means those who are working mainly on the laptop and all. Now what happens? What happens when you start working? The very moment you see me, you look at me, I have rested both my hands on the table and I'm speaking to you guys. But what happened to you people when you start working on a laptop? When you start working on a laptop or whatever it is, if your posture is not good enough, what happens to your spine? The spine here in this picture, what I'm showing, here it is, this is the spine picture of it, and the upper part of the spine, coming to the spine, the upper part of the spine, what we call it as cervical spine. The cervical spine, it has got 7 vertebrae as I've previously mentioned in my previous programs and all. So these 7 vertebrae, it should maintain this minimum bit of curvature. If this minimum bit of curvature is not maintained, if you start coming forward and if you start leaning forward, what happens is the curvature of the spine is lost and it becomes straight. So what happens, the muscles behind the spine, they get overstretched. The ligaments behind the spine, they get overstretched. So coming to the neck part of the thing, there are many issues called as forward neck posture and upper cervical spine pain and all those things. So these things, usually these pains, they usually radiate to from the neck or from the upper neck, they radiate to either sides of the head. Also, these pains also might radiate wherever the cervical spine nerve roots, they get supplied. If the nerve root get irritated, that area or that muscle of the cervical spine or the muscles, they get irritated, the muscles go into spasm, everything, all the havoc sets in, and literally there will be a crosslock, absolute lock at the cervical spine, leading to a stiff neck and inability to move around, inability to turn around, and a lot of pain which will be concerning and which will be really disturbing you in your daily activities and work. This is regarding the upper cervical spine. This is purely the muscular part or the soft tissue irritation part. There can be another thing also. As I have previously mentioned in my Telugu videos and all, there can be a disc bulge or a disc prolapse at any of the level, and more so common the C5 and C6 levels of the cervical spine most commonly, and that disc prolapse can lead to impingement of the nerve leading to the radiculopathy and all issues or nerve pain issues. Whenever the nerve gets irritated, there will be a pain dragging down the arm or the upper limb or the hand or wherever the nerve is supplying to. So this is the neurological part of it. Also, there can be, because of the posture and all, your blood vessels which come out of the thorax, we call it as thoracic outlet vessels, neurovascular bundle and all. So if you have extra cervical ribs, etc., etc., and all those things, these are many wonderful words you find on the net if you start Googling it. So my sincere request for all the patients or all the individuals who have this neck pain because of posture, they think or you think because of posture and all, whenever you think that there is some postural issue or if you are having some neck pain and all, what you do is better consult your nearby therapist or an orthopedician or an orthopedician basically to get rid of all the doubts. Do not Google it, do not discuss with those people who just have an idea but not professionally into the things and all. So basically discuss with those guys or those professionals like orthopedician or a physiotherapist, get an idea, proper idea about the reason behind the neck pain or reason behind the headache, what we commonly call it as neck induced headache, or sometimes even there can be some fancy names like cervicogenic headache, most commonly misleading into migraine. Few people think it is migraine. So never ever when you start working on a visual display unit, you tend to obviously go into a bad posture, and because of this, postural issues or posture induced pains can happen. Also, there can be some pre-existing illness like migraine or cervicogenic headache which is predisposingly which could be present, but these, especially cervicogenic headaches and all, they get irritated or they get induced because of your improper posture and all. So never come to your own conclusion by watching any videos or anything. These are just for your educational purpose or for your idea purpose. Only best thing is to have a proper knowledge. First and the foremost thing is, don't get panic if you have any neck pain or a headache and all. First, try to find out if there is any postural induced causes or not. These things you can easily find out by maintaining proper posture. So how to maintain a proper posture? Regarding neck, how to maintain a proper posture? First and the foremost thing is sit straight with the neck proper in proper position. In a side angle view, you should maintain the curvature of the neck, and also do not lean the head forward. Do not do this sniffing position. When you start doing this sniffing position, and if you see in the side view, if you start doing the chin forward or a sniffing position, what will happen? Your upper cervical muscles will get irritated, and you often have just a pain exactly at the junction between head and the neck. This is the most common complaint from the IT guys or the visual display unit workers and all. Coming to the mid cervical issues or the between, when you see in the image, the upper cervical issues will lead to the suboccipital pain or the pain which is just beneath the skull behind and all. And mid spinal issues or the mid cervical nerve root compression issues, you will have pain radiating down the upper limb and all because of compression of certain nerve roots. Let's not go into the depth of the root values and all. This is not for your education and all. It's just for your idea. So going to that, this is the main important thing wherein if you don't support your upper limbs properly over a table, chances of that, more often than not, you might be overstretching your neck muscles or the upper shoulder muscle called as trapezius muscle. The upper part of the trapezius muscle, which is above the shoulder here, you end up in overstretching it, thereby leading to either trapezitis or trapezius muscle strain, or there could be certain trigger points developing in that area or in the muscle, again which leads to your pain into the radiating pain or referred pain into the neck or into down the arm and all. These are the common things regarding the mid cervical spine and lower cervical spine. So what I say seriously is, first thing is to correct the posture by properly maintaining the neck position. Do not stoop or do not do the chin forward techniques. And third main important thing is supporting your upper limb. The supporting the upper limbs is one of the most important things. At least 8 out of 10 people who come to me with the neck pain and the upper trapezius pain, they get rid of just like that, they get rid of the pain just by supporting the upper limbs and also having some transient pain relief therapy with the help of medications given by the orthopedician, followed by regular postural correction by supporting the upper limbs, not leaving the upper limbs to the gravity. What happens is the loads on the muscles, they decrease. So all this, by making all these postural corrections and supporting to the upper limb and all, for sure you can avoid, most of the times you can avoid landing into painful situations or having a lot of trouble and all those things. So this is regarding neck, especially neck. Without support, for sure you people are going to land up with a lot of pain, which usually is treated by medications. They give a transient relief, but rather than that, or more than that, the postural correction helps you a lot. Absolutely, it helps a lot, especially in visual display unit workers. The whole idea and the whole topic of my speech now is for visual display unit workers or those who are into IT profession and all. Now coming to the back, upper back, what happens? When you see your spine here in the upper back, here, this upper back, it is convex backside and concave in the front side. So when this upper back, if you do too much of forward bending and all, the structures over the back can get overstretched. There is a thing like there is something called as thoracolumbar fascia, we call it as technically. That is basically the back soft tissue, the upper back and the back soft tissue, muscles, the fascia and all, they get overstretched, and that gives a lot of pain. Because of overstretch and all, it gives a lot of pain. Also, before giving pain, you might end up having a humpback or a forward tilt, or what we call it as rounded shoulders and all. These rounded shoulders and forward neck posture, a combination of these two will cause a rounded thoracic spine or the upper back with rounded shoulders and forward neck will cause a syndrome called as upper cross syndrome. This position, if you regularly adapt for your work, obviously it can change into a permanent postural anomaly called as rounded shoulders or upper cross syndrome. This leads to a lot of pain both in the neck and upper back. The first and the foremost postural correction for this, I suggest, is having a full support till the shoulders, means sitting in a chair with full support till the shoulders, then having the shoulders. The main problem with upper cross syndrome is having a rounded shoulders and a chin forward. Obviously, all your soft tissues are either overstretched or shortened. Some of the soft tissues or some of the muscles are shortened and the opposite group of muscles are overstretched. So because of this imbalance in the muscles and fascia, imbalance in the muscle power or muscle length and all, you will be landing up with bad postures with excessive stress on or excessive undue stress on the soft tissues, leading to severe pains and all. So basically the first and the foremost thing, postural correction, is having the shoulders retracted back or pulled back, sit straight such that your upper spine or the upper back touches the complete chair, having a chair fully supported till the upper back. What happens to you? You will have a proper position, taking your neck back and sitting straight into the visual display unit. By doing these postural corrections, you will avoid overstretch on the soft tissues on the back. Also, you will also avoid shortening of the soft tissues in the front or the muscles in the front. This actually helps a lot in avoiding any upper shoulder, or in fact to say more than shoulder and upper back pains, thereby helping you walking easily around. And coming to the upper back to lower back junction, this is one of the most crucial thing. The upper back to lower back junction, when you see in a spine, the upper back to lower back junction, this is the place where your curvatures revert. This reversal of curvatures will lead to certain changes, certain mechanical issues and certain physiological issues also. So what I suggest here is, in short, maintaining the posture such that you have your curvatures of the spine properly maintaining. So if you sit in a posture which is ideally suiting to maintain the curvatures of the spine, it will help in reducing most of the postural issues or posture induced musculoskeletal issues, especially for IT guys. So the main take home message from this point is, or from this part of the discussion, is: one, straight neck; two, supported upper back; three, supported lower back; four, sit up straight in a proper chair; five, supporting the hands on a table without letting them go down for gravity; and six, adjusting the monitor or the visual display unit up into the eye level, up into the eye level, such that what happens is, by doing so, you need not go down or bend down your neck and all. These are minimal changes which one can actually do at their own workplace or at even the home place. Now, don't complain that I don't have a proper setup to sit at home. Unfortunately, because of this pandemic, I do say pandemic is absolutely an unfortunate thing. But fortunately for IT guys, most of the places they have reimbursed or the companies have suggested you. The companies are good enough to actually reimburse or they are in fact working for the goodness and wellness of the IT employees. So better take proper advice or use all the resources from the company what you work in. Have proper laptops, have proper monitors, proper level of monitors at the eye level, and also maintain proper posture. Always work in such an environment. Work environment is pretty important. Why? Because work in such an environment where it really supports your upper back or the back, lower back, neck and shoulders, which is very important in maintaining. And you people might ask me one thing. Okay, doctor, or okay, physio, what is a good posture? Guys, let me tell you, there's nothing called as good posture. Always change in posture is better. This was taught to me by one of my gurus and one of my professional gurus. And yes, it's true. It's true that there's nothing called as good posture. It's always change in posture which is absolutely better. You people don't know one important thing that, I mean, you hear people saying that I sleep absolutely like a book and get up like a book. I don't even move this way or that way. No, it is their own misconception. Technically, science say that at least an individual overnight, during an overnight sleep, an individual will move at least 100 to 108 times, including all the movements of upper limbs, lower limbs, spine and all this way and that way. Usually an individual moves for at least 108 times over one single night. There's nothing called as sound sleep. So there's nothing called as good posture. Sound sleep is that sleep where you mentally relax, but physically there'll be a lot of movement happening. Body will adjust, actually the musculoskeletal system along with the brain will act coordinatedly to adjust for change in posture all the time. So one dictum or one thing you need to remember is there is no good posture. Always change in posture is better. So to have a proper healthy spine or to have a pain-free back or a pain-free neck, what to do? First is to have a good posture, as I said. Two, to get up and change the posture every 1 hour or so, walk around so that the blood in the legs circulate. You don't leave the legs like that. You don't leave the legs motionless for hours together. Just don't sit at one place. Get up, walk around for a minute or two. Let the blood circulate in the legs. Let the things happen properly. Next, also do some minimal movements of the body, spine. Do some minimal rotatory movements of the spine or the back, or do some movements of the upper limbs and all. Keep the body moving. Keep the body moving. Don't let the body stay static for hours together. Don't do blunders and then come back to the doctor and say, I need a therapy or I need a session where I get relieved just like that quickly. No, please don't. It's a humble request from all the healthcare professionals for the IT guys. Please take care of your back. Take care of your spine, take care of your body. In fact, this session, what I would like to convey is not only your spine and back. It is not only your spine and back. Don't worry about the disc prolapse in the back and disc prolapse in the neck. Fine. It's okay. Even if you have disc prolapse, until and unless it is clinically significant that you have some tingling, numbness or loss of motor power or pain which is very bad till, you know, thing is it wakes you up in the mid of the night and all. Till such time, it's not a big worry thing. Even at that time, it's not a big worry thing, big thing to worry, because we are here there to help you out. But maintaining posture, maintaining a good or maintaining a better posture, as I said, change in the posture, maintaining proper musculoskeletal health is there in your hands, and do exercise regularly to maintain fitness. And last but not the least, I would like to say one thing. Many people come to me with another important segment called as tailbone pain. So guys, what I would like to suggest to you, see here in this the end of the spine, you have got a sacral bone. As I said in the previous videos in Telugu, that the sacral bone is fused. Actually, the sacral bone is also it also contains five pieces of bones, you know, but still all the five pieces get fused to form a single bone, at the end of which there is one tailbone called as coccyx. Sacrum is that bone which attaches to your pelvis on both sides, but this tailbone, coccyx, most of the people complain with a lot of pain at the tailbone. So what happens? What actually is this tailbone pain? Because you people, instead of sitting up straight, when you sit up straight like this, see, the tailbone is not getting compressed. If you are maintaining a proper spine, only the tip of the tailbone will get or will be in touch with. But when you sit in a slouched position, or when you sit down with a curved back totally curved position, what happens is the tailbone bears a lot of pain from the tailbone bears a lot of pressure from the seat, and most of the pressure which is to be dissipated onto your buttocks gets completely concentrated on the tailbone. Now this actually causes inflammation or excessive stress on the tailbone, leading to tailbone pain called as a coccydynia. Obviously, most often the not the signs and symptoms are while sitting you have pain, then again while trying to get up initially you will have pain, but after getting up you will be having less pain. So the best, first and the foremost thing and the best treatment for all these things is, if you feel that there is a lot of muscle induced pain or muscle catch or a strain, after meeting your orthopedician and getting diagnosed it as mechanical low back pain only. Now why I am stressing so much in meeting your doctor or a professional is, guys, remember there are n number of things which can mimic back pain, but they are not directly the musculoskeletal reasons of the back pain. As I already said in the previous videos, there can be other visceral issues or other infective causes for back pain, infection of the spine, infection of the disc, discitis, or sometimes even in very few people there can be a predisposition of tuberculosis spine, sometimes mimicking as simple radiating pain or continuous back pain. People tend to neglect such pains. So whenever you have a back pain or neck pain, first don't try home remedies continuously. Okay, home remedies are good for a day or two. Like as I said in the previous videos, lie down properly with full support for 48 hours on a proper surface, on a properly hard and equally supporting surface, and put a pillow under the knees, have a proper relaxed posture, lie down for a day or two, just getting up for the activities like food and attending the nature calls and all. But other than that, better stay on bed. Still, if you don't get any relief, and even during these 24 hours or 48 hours, if the pain start increasing, please do not neglect. Please do not have ideas from the videos or WhatsApp videos or Googling it and all those things. First, meet a consultant. Get it diagnosed. Get your back and neck pain or the upper back pain diagnosed properly. And once it is diagnosed properly, and if it turns to be a mechanical back pain only, which is more often 95 to 99% most often it will be mechanical back pain only. Get it diagnosed to be mechanical back pain. Get it stamped by a consultant. Yes, this is a mechanical back pain. And then follow these postural correction techniques and all those things. Then for sure you will be getting a lot of relief. Implement these postural correction techniques as well as movement and other techniques, getting up for every 1 hour and all. Even if you go back to office tomorrow after the lockdown is lifted, once you are back to office, keep these things going, keep these things happening. Move around. I always say static posture is not at all good. There is nothing called as good posture. Always change in posture is better. So do that. Have a proper healthy spine. And once your back and your core is good, because spine forms the main core of all the body. Once your core is good, obviously you will feel fit, you will feel more healthy and more elated as well as more energetic. For further specific details and all, do follow the video. You people have my number in the video. Always you can come to the clinic or you can call me. There is nothing called as this is not, this video is not for a commercial purpose. So you can even call me directly. I'll give my part of advice over the phone, whichever is possible. But still, if it needs to be evaluated, please, please, please go and meet your consultant. First, get it checked, get it stamped, or confirm it to be a mechanical back pain only. Else then, wonderfully, you can recoup, re-energetize, and have a happy life. Thank you all. And for further queries and all, please do comment. Please do put your queries in the comment section, or you can give me a call directly. But guys, take care. Have a healthy spine. Have a happy life. Thank you all.